I am Meenakshi and we are meeting again for the next session of grammars. And today we will discuss about noun numbers. So first we should know that what is noun. Nouns are naming words. Alright, name of a person, place, things or any abstract, they are called nouns. Alright, and about the noun numbers. First, we should know that how we can count the numbers. There are some countable nouns and some uncountable nouns. Countable nouns are those to whom we can count. Alright? Like there are some apples in the basket. Those apples, we can count them. But if I say that, please pour a sugar in my cup of tea, then that is wrong. Instead of that, I can say that please pour a cube of sugar in my cup of tea or a spoon of sugar in my cup of tea. But some people get confused that what are countable and what are uncountable. So it's easy to recognize that what are uncountable nouns to whom we can't count. Okay, we can't count them. For example, sugar, milk, chocolate. Alright, we can make these uncountable nouns uncountable by adding a unit with them, like a cube of sugar. Now they are countable. A glass of milk. A bar of chocolate. Now they are countable. And countable nouns are those to which we can count. We can count them. They are of two types, singular and plural. Singular means one object, one person, and plural means more than one. Alright? Like apple, apples, its plural is apples. Boy, boy is singular, boys are plural. Ox, ox is singular, oxen are plural. Mouse, mouse is singular, mice are plural. Like this, man, men, woman, women, they are singular and plurals. Now we will discuss that how we can make a singular noun into a plural one. How we can change them. There are several types through which we can change a singular noun to the plural one. First of all, most basic uses by adding S at the end of any noun. By adding S, we can make a singular noun into plural noun. Like boy, by adding S, I have made it plural, more than one. Chairs, pens, oranges, etc. Alright? And another example is, another type is how we can make singular one into plural by adding ES. We add ES in some cases when there is this sound at the end. At the end there is S, double S, SH, CH, X or Z. We call these words that ends with these letters, we call these sounds hissing sounds also. They sound like s, s, sh, ch, s, z. We can add es behind them and can make them plural. For example, watch, here ch is at the end, it would be watches. Fox, foxes, s sound, dress, dresses. All right. Next, some nouns that ends with O. We can make plural of those nouns by adding ES. For example, tomato, tomatoes. Add ES if there is O. Like mango, mangoes. But still whereas in some cases there is O, but we can't add ES there. We will add S only. For example, photo, photos, zero, zeros. There is no any particular rule that where the S is used and where ES is used. Next, if any word is ending with Y or Y, then we would change this Y into I and add ES behind it. For example, family, families. In this case, this rule follows that if there is a consonant before Y, it's a consonant, then it would change into IES. And if there is a vowel before Y, suppose monkey, there is vowel before Y. It's a vowel before Y. So, this Y would not change into I. It would become monkeys. Alright, this rule follows with in case of Y. Next, if the noun word ends with the F or FE, then F would change into V and ES would be added. VES. For example, knife. Knife would become knives. And loaf. Loaf would become loaves. And again, there is confusing if there is F, still it won't change into VES. Like roof. In the case of roof, F would not change into V. It would still be F. Roofs. Alright. Next, in some nouns, they don't follow any rule. They change their spellings. Like ox become oxen, woman become woman, tooth become teeth, foot become feet, mouse become mice. In some cases their vowels change, like A into double E, double O change into double E. Their vowels change. Alright, next, in some cases, singular and plural, both the spellings are same. Those words are used with the singulars and plural as well. Singular and plural remain same. Those are deer, beer, sheep, sheep. Then next is in some nouns, a plural form is always used. For example, plural form is always used. Like scissors as always remain at the end. Binoculars. All right. In this furniture also remain same, singular and plural. And another thing is that when there is a compound noun, then main noun is changed. Compound, in the case of compound noun, like brother-in-law, this is compound noun. It would remain same and the main noun would be changed into plural. That would become brothers-in-law, sisters-in-law. Alright? So these were noun numbers that we discussed today. I hope that you have understand them all. And if you have any other question regarding this topic, you may ask in the comment box. Thanks and have a nice day. Bye.